Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church, Springfield, Ohio. Today is February 26, 2017. This is the Transfiguration of Our Lord. St. John's is located at 27 North Wittenberg Avenue, Springfield, Ohio. Our telephone number is 937-323-7508. Join us this Wednesday. We have two services for Ash Wednesday, 2 o'clock and 6:30 in the sanctuary. Beginning on March 8th, Wednesday Lenten services at 6:30 in the sanctuary with a light meal prior to the service. St. John's has an outreach store open Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and Friday, closed on Thursdays, 9:30 to 1 o'clock. The food pantry is open 9 to 10:45 every Wednesday. Rainbow table, 12 noon to 1 o'clock every Friday. Everyone is welcome.
Lutheran Church. This is a Transfiguration of Our Lord, February 26, 2017. This Wednesday is Ash Wednesday. We're happy to have you here. We're good friends to have you here with us, worshiping God together.
Oh God,
in the transfiguration of your Son, you confirm the mysteries of the faith by the witness of Moses and Elijah, and in the voice of the bright cloud declare Jesus your beloved Son. You foreshadow our adoption as a children. Make us heirs of Christ for your glory, and bring us to the joy of his fullness through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
You may be seated. Will the children come towards this door and meet Miss Nancy for Junior Church? And as they are moving, let us prepare our hearts to hear the words of God in our scriptures.
Been quiet eyewitnesses of his ministry.
Gospel be read by guest pastor, Pastor Catrina Hawkins-Bowles. Catrina Hawkins-Bowles, wonderful preacher. So stay tuned in, listen to her preaching. She's reading the Gospel.
The Holy Gospel according to Matthew, the 17th chapter.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus took with him Peter and James and his brother John and led them up a high mountain by themselves. And he was transfigured before them, and his face shone like the sun, and his clothes became dazzling white. Suddenly there appeared to them Moses and Elijah, talking with them. Then Peter said to Jesus, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, I will make three dwellings here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While he was still speaking, suddenly a bright cloud overshadowed them, and from the cloud a voice said, "This is my son, the beloved. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell to the ground and were overcome by fear. But Jesus came and touched them, saying, "Get up and do not be afraid." And when they looked up, they saw no one except Jesus himself alone. As they were coming down the mountain, Jesus ordered them, "Tell no one about the vision until after the Son of Man has been raised from the dead." This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
You may be seated. Grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I do apologize. There is special music. We're going to be entertained first.
Becky Demetroff will provide special music today.
Please pray with me. Gracious God, you remind us of the gift of transfiguration, a decision, an intention to be transformed by you. Give us courage to be willing to take this journey. Give us strength to make it every step of the way. And give us boldness to tell people what we learned about. Amen. After I read the scriptures, I said to my husband, I said, Kev, now the first reading that we have is the reading that I based my Hebrew paper on. I told him, I said, that we had to talk about and specify a Hebrew word, and then we had to go through all the definitions on what it means and analyze and all of this stuff. One of the words that I picked was glory. In our 17th verse of this Exodus chapter, now the appearance of the glory of the Lord was like a devouring fire on the top of the mountain. This idea of glory, the kabod, the Hebrew word for glory, kabod of God, the awesomeness and amazingness of the glory, the magnificence, because that glory is magnified, and the awesomeness of the perception of the people in watching it. And so the reason why this Exodus text is used for transfiguration is that it mirrors what our gospel lesson is. And in our gospel lesson, we have another mountaintop experience. This Exodus text was the mountaintop experience for Moses. But now we have one for Jesus and the three. And I'll just make sure you all know, Peter, James, and John, if you hear the three, those are the three they're talking about. Peter, James, and John. They are part of Jesus' inner circle. Throughout the New Testament, there are many stories and miracles and things that you see that only Peter, James, and John were invited to be a part of. These were Jesus' closest of the 12. And so he brought them up there to witness what was taking place. And once again, we have this magnificent mountain story. What they saw on the mountain, what they experienced on the mountain. Interestingly enough, humans in this day and age have times where we all get a chance to have a mountaintop experience. These are the experiences that you go through where you feel a tangible touch from God in your life. Where you know you are never going to be the same again. Where what was is no longer. The pain that could have been is no longer possible. The guilt, the shame, the fear. The mountaintop experience that take you out of the brokenness of humanity into the healing power of God. If you're lucky, on this side of the world, on this side of heaven, you will get a chance to see the face of God in God's tangible miracles of love. Some of you may not experience some of those things. And sometimes those experiences can be very hard and difficult to live through. But when you get to the other side, you are not the same. I want you to know that we did not have a whole bunch of questions today because I don't need my walker anymore. I haven't been here for a year, so y'all don't know what happened to me. Y'all don't know my recent mountaintop experience. But because I'm special and unique, as you all know, I got a chance to have a rare diagnosis that most people, if they're not doctors, never heard of. It's called cauda equina, a Latin word. Stands for horse's tail. if you got the finer part of that. And what it is that at the bottom of your spine are a whole bunch of nerves in the shape of a horse's tail, and they control your whole bottom half. Your ability to walk, your ability to go to the bathroom normally, everything at the bottom of your body, these nerves control. But because I happen to be African American, people did not believe that I needed help. And so it was only until I could no longer walk and was in a wheelchair that they actually believed and gave me an MRI. I was rushed into surgery at OSU at 11 o'clock at night. And I'm not a paraplegic. This is one of the many mountaintop experiences in my life. God has done amazing things for me so that I could be here with you. If I was still at my first church, y'all would never have met me. But I left there because the transfiguration that was happening in me told me I had to be what God said we had to be. We have to be bold truth tellers. We cannot be ashamed of the gospel. We cannot be afraid to tell what God has already shown to us through Jesus. Like I said, this was just the last of my mountaintop experiences. But knowing the power of God to protect me, not only to protect me from paralyzation, but to protect me from incontinence. Can you imagine a 35-year-old woman with a 6-year-old child and they need a diaper? But that's what was happening to me, and God said no. I may have lost my ability to walk at that point, but I never needed a diaper. It sounds funny to say, but when you think about the idea, the preposterous idea, I've told people, I said, I had no idea there was something that could happen to your back that could cause paralysis and you not have a car accident. I didn't know there was something. But because of what happened, the mountaintop experience, the transfiguration experience, the renewal experience. See, one of the things that I learned on one of my many mountaintop experiences is that Jesus came into this world so that we don't have to stay broken. When we break the body of Christ in our communion, we are breaking something that died so we don't have to be broke. So that we don't have to be hurt. So that we don't have to live in pain, in shame, in guilt, in despair, in chaos. See, the purpose of this is so that we may have life and have it more. Of God and the evidence of the resurrection. that Jesus came into the world to begin with. It is because of us that Jesus died. And it is through us that Jesus can continue to help this world. Tell your story. What mountaintop has God allowed you to see? How has God transfigured you into being more like Him? This is what transfiguration is about. Allowing ourselves to become more like the Jesus who loves us. And in turn, we can change this world. Amen. Let us sing, "I Want Jesus to Walk with Me," hymn 325.
This is an African-American plantation song, "I Want Jesus to Walk with Me," African-American spiritual. No one knows who wrote these songs, but they were assembled by the Jubilee Singers in Nashville, and they've been preserved for us. We have more than 1,000 now. African-American spirituals, plantation songs, "I Want Jesus to Walk with Me." Sing this with spirit.
For the church, Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the lonely, that they might know the abiding presence of the Lord in the community of the saints gathered around Christ in his word and sacrament, and thereby find fellowship, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
We offer up to you any prayers that we keep silent or that we confess to you out loud. Hear the prayers of your saints, O Lord, knowing where two or three are gathered together, so you are present also. Into your hands, dear Father, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. Amen.
You may be seated as we give our offerings to God.
Welcome to St. John's Lutheran Church. We're happy to have you join us. Stay tuned for the rest of our service and commune with us, be with us, worship with us. We have the offering now. Lent starts soon. Ash Wednesday is coming right up. This coming Wednesday is Ash Wednesday. And we start with Lent, 40 days of Lent, and it ends with the resurrection and Easter. Today is the Transfiguration of Our Lord, February 26, 2017. This is what we talked about, and we have a guest pastor, Pastor Bowles today, Pastor Pollock. John Pollock is our usual pastor. He's out of town, and our pastor is Pastor Catrina Hawkins-Bowles, who's shared with us today that she has gone through Claudia Aquinas syndrome and surgery, and has been healed by God. Praise God for that. Stay with us for the rest of the service. Our last hymn is Shine, Jesus, Shine. Very upbeat hymn. We have an upbeat service today. And we start Lent on Ash Wednesday, this Wednesday. We're happy to have service today here at St. John's. And Ben O'Dell was the reader. Mary and Bill Nevius are the ushers. Next week is Holy Communion. We have Wednesday service at 1:30, and then at 6:30 for Ash Wednesday. We have Business and Professional Women's Club will meet for dinner on March the 7th at 5:30 at Heffel's Winery. All women are welcome, and this is at 5:30. Youth Roundup is Sunday, March the 5th after church. There'll be a meeting of all youth to brainstorm events and church goals for an acolyte schedule. Pizza will be provided, so make sure to be there as part of the planning. March the 5th, reminder news. Our garage sale is May the 4th, 5th, and 6th. We're happy to have you with us today worshiping. We hope that you receive Jesus Christ into your heart if not, made him Lord of your life. Pray today. Say, Lord Jesus, I repent. Come into my heart. I will serve you. Make me Lord of your life. Make him Lord of your life. Jesus Christ can be Lord of your life. Just invite him to come in, and he's right there at the door waiting.
Let us pray. Merciful Father, we offer these our gifts for the sake of the one who gave first to us. Receive them and restore all things that we need with love and honor and praise to the glory of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. Let us pray together the prayer that our Lord Jesus first taught us to pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
Let us sing our closing hymn, Shine, Jesus, Shine, hymn 671.
Our closing hymn today is Shine, Jesus, Shine. It's written by Catherine Kendrick, who was born in 1950. It's a rather modern hymn. It's a hymn of witness, Shine, Jesus, Shine. Join us, sing us, with us today. We hope you know it. Shine, Jesus, Shine, fill this land with your Father's glory. This is in honor of the Transfiguration when God transfigured Jesus on the mountaintop and the light was there. Shine, Jesus, shine. Watching us on YouTube, please spread the word to other people. If you have a computer or a portable computer, take it to somebody's house and witness to them. Thank you for watching on YouTube, and you can take this service to any shut-in or anybody to witness to them. This is February 26th. We're celebrating the Transfiguration of our Lord, and that's the last Sunday before Lent. Then we start Lent with Ash Wednesday on Wednesday. We're happy to have guest pastor, Pastor Catrina Hawkins-Bowles, who gave a wonderful sermon, spiritual sermon for us today. We're very thank God that she was able to get through the surgery for cauda equina syndrome. She's healed and brought back to us. She could have been paralyzed. We're very thankful that she got through the surgery and she's back with us. She has preached with us here before. Very pleased to have her preaching today back to health. We have Ash Wednesday service at 2 o'clock this week and also 6:30. Then we start the Wednesday services. Pastor will have service every Wednesday during Lent. We invite you to come at 6:30 for each worship service during Lent. Ash Wednesday is March the 1st, Lenten services each Wednesday starting March the 8th. Light Supper 5 to 6:15, evening service 6:30. Lent begins Ash Wednesday. Also, we want to invite you to come next week to our services. We have beginning of Lent, first Sunday in Lent. We have Holy Communion. We also have Holy Communion for Ash Wednesday, Imposition of the Ashes, where we learn and we repeat again that God is our Creator. He has created us. We're thankful for that. He's with us every minute of every day. We're happy to have you worship with us anytime. We're at the corner of Wittenberg and Columbia. We have a ministry to the local people. We provide food and we also provide services and social services, what is needed. We have a rainbow table every Friday. We feed people a meal. Flowers today are from Carol Glaze in memory of Ben Glaze's birthday and Donna Peer in honor of Linda Anderson's birthday. We've been looking at the flowers and the people now taking the flowers away, but they were there with us. A lot of flowers, beautiful flowers at our altar today. We want to remember in prayer those who need healing: Jennifer Dade, Patty Malone, Bill Stump, Pauline Stouch, Anna Spechtel, Linda Harrison, any others we don't know about. We're happy to have you come to St. John's Lutheran Church. Next Wednesday is Ash Wednesday, and then on Sunday we start again with 8 o'clock service and 10:30 services every Sunday and Sunday school in between. Remember that the Youth Roundup is March the 5th. Business and Professional Women's Club will meet for dinner on March the 7th. A lot of things coming up. Garage sale March 4th, 5th, and 6th. We thank God for all of you. We pray for you and our help, our ministry on YouTube. We're happy to have you watch our broadcast. We thank you for joining us in worship on this Lord's Day. We hope and we pray that God will continue to bless you, keep you this day and all your days. We will pray for you. Continue to pray for us and our YouTube ministry.
Really? Yeah. Yeah, it's scary when you let your kids go.